What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I have a really interesting topic, and that is how to create a perfect or a unilateral or a hexagon that all sides are the same length, like a perfect hexagonal facade or pattern inside of Revit. Because if you don't know that, well, Revit doesn't have a perfect hexagon. When you create a hexagon facade in Revit, it isn't a perfect hexagon. It's an awful hexagon. So I actually wanted to create this facade, and I wanted to create a tutorial on how that's designed. But then I realized that Revit doesn't really allow you to create a perfect hexagon. At least it's not easy. You have to follow a workaround. And then I thought, okay, let's split this into two tutorials. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create just a perfect hexagonal panel. And then in the next video, I'm going to be showing you how to apply that hexagon panel to an interesting facade inside of Revit. So I thought this could be kind of a cool set of a couple of tutorials. Now, if you want to learn more about Revit, I actually have a website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and also up in the cards above. There you can find my advanced Revit courses. And for example, for something like this, modeling panels, I have an entire course on advanced modeling in Revit where we use conceptual massing and the conceptual massing environment, and I show you how to create all sorts of different complex shapes and buildings inside of Revit. Also, I have many different courses on many different topics. There is over 130 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month, so make sure to check that out. Also, there you can find my customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families and a plugin. And now, before we get into the actual video, just make sure to like this video. It helps me out a lot. And make sure to subscribe. Not only does it help you not miss any of my future videos, but it makes the alpaca happy, and I want to make the alpaca happy. Okay, now let's jump into Revit. And as you can see, here we are at the home screen in Revit. And even though this is going to be like a tutorial where I show you how to create the panel, I want to start first with a project where we're going to be applying that panel. So let's go here to models, let's go to new, and then here I'm just going to go to I'm going to be using my architecture design template, the metric version. So that's the one that's available on my website. And then as soon as Revit starts up, this is like just the home screen, so let's go to the 3D view. There we go. And now let's first create that pattern of where we have that awful hexagon. So I'm going to go here to massing and sight. I'm going to go to show mass and go to in place mass. This is going to open up a new mass. So it's called mass one. That's perfectly fine. You can rename it if you want. And then just to keep things simple, I'm going to go and use a simple line and then place a simple line here. Let's make it 1600. Okay, just like that. Hit the escape key a few times. So we have this just the simple one line. Then we go to create form, and it's going to extrude that up, and we can just make it a bit taller. Perhaps go up to 8 meters or something like that. Oops, not 8,000, 800 centimeters or 8 meters. Okay, so once we have a surface, so if you hover over the edge, it's going to just highlight the edge. But if you hit the tab key once, it's going to highlight the entire thing. And then when you click the select, you have an entire surface. Now, once you have a surface, you can divide it by going here to divide surface. And that's going to create a surface division such as this one. Okay, now if I go here to the properties, you can see all of the different sorts of patterns that are available, but the one that I'm interested in is the hexagon pattern. And if I click there, this is what we get. Now, this isn't a perfect hexagon by any measure. Now I can go here and let's change the layout to fixed distance on both U and V grids. Perhaps expand this. There we go. So both U and V grids to fix distance. And let's make it equal. Let's make it, let's go 100 by 100. Hit apply. Let's see what happens. Well, we get this. It's a bit closer, but nowhere near. Let's turn on the surface as well. And now here we can see the nature of our problem. So basically, these hexagons are made inside of 6 fields. And no matter how you set these up, these sides here will never be as long as this side here. So because they have to be equal, they have to be 6 equal rectangles. Yeah, you can change the height and the width of them, but no matter how you change it, it's never going to give you a perfect hexagon with equal sides. So what do we do now? Well, now it's time to create a panel that's going to override this or override this issue. So how do we do that? Well, I'm just going to go here to File, New, Family. And then here under Family Categories or Family Templates, we have an option to select Curtain Panel Pattern Based. This is how you create any sort of panel for Revit. And let's open that up. And as soon as that opens up here, we can select this. We can change that to a hexagon. So here we see that horrible hexagon. Let's make this 1000 by 1000 millimeters or 1 by 1 meters. There we go. Okay, and how do we now change this? Well, we're just going to be making some adjustments to these points, moving the top points out and the side points in, and that's going to give us the perfect hexagon in the end. Now, when it comes to this workflow, I actually found it on another YouTuber's channel. His channel name is Ben. He's a Revit study channel. He actually does some really cool things. He goes into math in depth for this particular family, so you can check him out. I think it's really interesting if you want to kind of explore the math behind this thing. But I'm just going to be showing you kind of simply step by step how to do it in the quickest and easiest way. Okay, so now what you want to do is you want to host points on these existing points that can then be adjusted to move a little bit out. As I said, on the bottom and the top, it's going to move out, and then here on the sides, it's going to move in. So what you want to do is go to Set Work Plane. You want to select this vertical plane like that. Then you go to the point tool and make sure that you set it to draw on work plane so it pastes it exactly on that work plane. And then we can just click here to paste that point, click the escape key a few times. Then you want to select that point and move it out a little bit. So you'll see that here the offset is minus 200. So basically, if I select this point, I can control its position here from this offset. If I go minus 300, it's going to go out. If I go minus 100, it's going to go a little bit towards the inside. So this can easily be controlled through that parameter. And then you do the same thing on the other ones. So you go again to Set Work Plane, set it to this one, point, draw on work plane, place it there, hit the escape key a few times, and then you just pull it out. Now on these ones on the inside or on the sides, you just go to Set Work Plane again, you go to place point, you place it, but then for this one, you're going to be moving these on the inside. So the same thing goes on the other side. So these just go in. Just like that, and then we move this one in, and then again on top, I'm just going to set it to these and move them out. It's very simple. It's a little bit repetitive, unfortunately, which I don't like, but I guess that the solution is well worth the extra steps. Okay, so this is what we have. So now we just want to adjust these in a way where the new hexagon will follow these points, and that's going to make this a perfect hexagon with equal edges on all sides. But first, we want to control this offset parameter. Now, the issue is here we have an offset of minus 200, and this one is around 200. So this one is going in positive values, and this one is going in negative values. So we need to add a couple of parameters to control the negative and positive values. So I'm going to select this one. This one has negative values. So if I go here to associate family parameter, I can create a new parameter and then make sure it's an instance parameter, and let's call it the Z negative. Okay, click OK. Click OK again, and there we go. So this one is set to minus 200, and you can hit apply. Now this one's positive, this one is negative, so I can just associate that Z negative, and it's going to jump to 200. Okay, here this one's positive, this one's negative, so let's assign that Z negative. Hit apply. Now they're all at 200, so now if I go here to family types, if I make a change to this, so let's say minus 500 and hit apply, all three of these have moved to that value, which is really cool. Let's go to back to minus 200. Okay, so let's create a new parameter for the positive values. So you go here to the offset, you click, and then you create a new parameter, and this one is just Z, and also an instance parameter, that's important. Click OK again. We can make that 200 as well. Okay, and then you go to, this one is already set up, yes. This one isn't. Okay, associate family parameter, Z. And then finally this one, again, associate family parameter, and then Z. Okay, so once we have this, now we want to connect these two parameters so they work together. So now if I go here, I can just say that the Z negative equals minus Z and hit apply. So now if I change the Z to 500 and hit apply, all of them will change to that new value. Now let's go back, let's set it back to 200, hit apply. Okay, so now we want to know how do we control what that offset should be. Well, we can get that from the distance from 1 to 2, from these initial points. So how do we get that value? Well, we have to create something that's called a reporting parameter. This parameter isn't set up, it just reports what's going on. So you can set up a reporting parameter by going here to set work plane, select the horizontal work plane, then you go to the dimension tool, align the dimension, and then you just go from point to point and you place that parameter here. So as you know, it's 1000 because this grid has been set up to 1000 by 1000. Now I can select this, go to label, create parameter, and here I can make it an instance parameter, but check on the reporting parameter, and then I can call this one the reporting parameter. Okay, so once I have the reporting parameter created, I can just click OK, there we go, and then if I go here to family types, let's expand this a little bit, I can say that I want the Z value to be reporting parameter divided by 6 because it's a hexagon. Click OK, and now that's going to give me the value that's going to turn this into a perfect hexagon. Now we're still not there. This will work in conjunction with the parameters that we're going to set up here for the surface itself, so just keep that in mind. Now before we finish with this family, obviously you can see that it's still not done. We still have to make the panel itself. So what I'm going to do is select these reference planes because we don't really need them. I'm just going to hide those for now. And then I want to connect these points that we have created. So you just hold the control key, you select two points, you go to spline through work plane, spline through points, and then you just check is reference. And then you just repeat. So here, this one, hold the control key, this one, spline through points, and then is reference. Okay, let's repeat that again. Spline through points, is reference. It might give you some warnings, that's okay. These we can ignore. Okay. And then we just have a couple more. Spline through points, is reference. And then let's just connect these two and we're done. Okay, so now once we have this chain or this new chain of reference planes, now what I have to do is I have to create a form. So I'm just going to go to create form, make it like this, and then the offset here, I'm going to create a new parameter. So let's go here, new parameter, and this is the panel thickness. Let's make it a type parameter, click OK again, and then we can set that to be, I don't know, let's set it to be 200, hit apply, yeah, this looks a little bit better, something like this. Oops, I think I've misspelled this, so let's edit that parameter. Okay. There we go. Okay, so once we have the panel completed, it makes sense to save this family, so I'm just going to save it here on my computer. I'm going to call it the perfect hexagonal panel, or hexagon panel. Hit save. And now we can load this into the project. So now I can just go here to load into project and close. Now it's loaded in. Now when I select these panels, what I can do now is just go here to the properties, and now below the hexagon we have the perfect hexagon panel. And if I check that one, I can apply that panel, and this is what we get. Now, it's, as I said, it's still not perfect. We still have to make one additional change, and that is to the U and V grids. So here we have the option to associate parameters for U and V grids. So I'm just going to go to the V grid and add a parameter for distance, and this is going to be parameter X. Let's make it an instance parameter. Let's make it a big X. Click OK, click OK again, and then let's apply, OK. And then for the U grid, I want to create a new parameter as well, and this one is going to be the Y parameter. Make it an instance parameter, and then click OK, OK again. So these have to follow a specific formula. So if I open up the family types here, you can see that here I can assign a formula, and I'm going to assign a formula here for Y. So Y is going to be equals equal to times, and then you just use a little star, two times square root, so that's SQRT, and then in parentheses 3, so square root of 3 divided by 3 times x. Or make sure that, that it follows the same sign that used here, so that's large x. And then that should be it. There we go. And now as you can see, this parameter has changed, and now when I hit apply, click OK, now this is a perfect hexagon panel, or a set of perfect hexagon panels, or each side is equal. So let me open this up. There we go. If I now go to the measure tool, and if I measure from here to here, from here to here, as you can see, it is the all of the sides are equal. And there you go. That was the this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it. I know this might be a bit of a more geeky thing to do, but I think it was really fun and interesting. And in the end, we do get that really cool hexagon panel facade. So I'm really happy with the way that this turned out. Also, as I said, there will be another tutorial where I use this to create a really cool hexagon facade. So make sure to subscribe for that. And if you want to get these families and this hexagon panel panel surface, you can find that on my Patreon page, which is going to be just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.